This part will be about the breed of dog, the Bullmastiff, which is surrounded by an enormous number of misconceptions for reasons that are incomprehensible to us. In connection with this, we have to mention that, for example, they are banned in several parts of Germany and Austria as a so-called fighting dog, which is of course not true about them. To know what it is up to you to choose a Bullmastiff as your future dog, let's take a look at the 7 points that a person thinking about buying a Bullmastiff should consider very carefully before making a purchase. In the last point, it will also be revealed whether the Bullmastiff is an ideal choice for a novice dog owner. In order not to accidentally miss the next parts of the series and to receive instant notifications about new parts, subscribe to our channel and also press the bell button. 1. A brief history of the Bullmastiff. Of course, discussions about the origin and history of Bullmastiffs do not rest, and several theories and ideas are existing. Their story dates back to 18th to 19th century England, where the Industrial Revolution was taking place and huge masses became impoverished, who also had trouble obtaining basic food sources for themselves. Circumstances have greatly increased the number of illegal poachers, who hunted either alone or in groups in forests owned by the local aristocracy. Since illegal poaching was punishable by death at that time, we can imagine the danger the poachers imposed on the legal hunters and the protectors of the game. There was a need for a dog who would be patient during the ambush, easily defeating any adult man with strong and good physique, but who would not tear his victim apart in order that the victim could be brought to justice. Bullmastiffs began to be formed to perform these difficult tasks, some by crossing mastiffs and bulldogs, and others by using the gamekeeper's night dog, documented as early as the 18th century. This excellent breed, which perfectly met these expectations, was officially recognized in 1924. 2. The personality of the Bullmastiff. The Bullmastiff is a huge, awesome-looking, full-muscle dog for the majority, with excellent guarding and protective instincts and abilities to this day. Compared to the ancient Bullmastiffs, we can already speak of a much more solid and moderate dog, which is partly due to World War II, after which barely a few dozen pieces survived. They inherited from their ancestors their immense physical strength and excellent instincts, almost automatically spotting those approaching with malicious intent. They are almost infinitely patient and tolerant of their family, usually alike with strangers, and can always be counted on in a situation of danger. Although there was a Bullmastiff in almost every English police station between the two world wars, and they also protected the diamond mines of the Kimberley Company of South Africa, they are now rarely used as a service dog, finding their place increasingly as protector and company for the families. 3. The size and fur of the Bullmastiff. Bullmastiffs typically have a height of 61 to 68 centimeters and an average weight of 41 to 59 kilograms. In recent times, partly due to fashion, there have been much more heavy individuals, but this is undesirable as it significantly impairs the mobility and workability of Bullmastiffs. The coat is short and dense, the colors can be different shades of yellow and reddish shades in striped version. Most of the early, ancient Bullmastiffs were described as striped ones, as this color variation hid them most effectively from poachers' eyes. For single-colored dogs, a black mask is mandatory, it is part of the breed standard description. 4. The trainability of the Bullmastiff. The Bullmastiff is basically a smart and well-trainable breed, however, it should also be noted that because of the bulldog's ancestors, they are sometimes prone to stubbornness. Compared to the ancient Bullmastiffs, for whom appearance did not matter, only weight, strength, working abilities, and efficiency, the majority of today's Bullmastiffs have already been bred for appearance and their working abilities decline significantly. However, there are still those who prefer the tight-muscled working line, and these dogs can be trained as a guard protector with awesome abilities. Of course, we should not expect all this from the more and more frequent, slow-moving show dogs, which can grow up to 70 kilograms of weight. Despite all this, of course, it would be foolish to expect from a dog of Mastiff and Bulldog mixture the clockwork precision similar to German working dogs. 5. The activity level of the Bullmastiff. The Bullmastiff, because of their stature, will never be the champion of long-term, repetitive forms of movement. Rather, they are among the panzers of the canine world, excelling in lightning-fast, irresistible seizures and movements that require short action, but require maximum effort. Just think of the reasons for their breeding and the conditions under which they were used. They did not follow or hunt animals for many, many kilometers, but overthrew poachers with a single successful attack. They like to walk, they also need to move, they like to play with other dogs, but in their own thoughtful, measured way. That's why anyone looking for a companion for dog sports shouldn't choose the Bullmastiff. 6. Bullmastiff health and longevity. Bullmastiffs typically have a lifespan of 10 to 12 years. Dogs with longer lifespans may rarely occur, but this is truly an exception to the rule. As with other molossers, they are occasionally affected by various types of dysplasia and musculoskeletal disorders and may have myocardial abnormalities. 7. And finally, the last question. Is the Bullmastiff ideal for a first-time dog owner? The answer to this question is rather no, despite the fact that the dangerous category in the German and Austrian territories mentioned in the introduction is, in our view, an extreme misinterpretation of the nature of this great dog, which is not uncommon in connection with other breeds as well. Although the Bullmastiff is one of the most excellent family dogs and almost the most patient with children, we must not forget that due to their enormous muscle strength, large body, stubbornness, and slow maturation process, its upbringing and control require more patience and experience than in average. If you have enough of these traits, or you have the professional help of a dog trainer, then the Bullmastiff is one of the most recommended breeds for those owners who, in addition to love, also expect a dog to be able to work, even if it is a molosser. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and also press the bell button to get notifications of new parts. Thank you very much for your attention.